Hi friends, I'm Anupriya. You're watching Vidyarthi. In this session, I have brought some words, or you can say little format of sentences of words which are actually popular as formal and informal English. Yes, in English language, we use few words which have a similar meaning, but they're different. The meaning, the words are different. And one place, at one place we are using that in a formal manner, and at one place we are using that in an informal manner. So they change the senses, not their meaning. So I'll pick the first one. First is, in the end. What is the meaning of this? In the end, we can call it finally. So finally is actually formal way of saying the same thing. I'll give you an example. Suppose I'm giving a public speech, I'm giving a speech on the stage, and I'm saying, it was really good to give a presentation in front of all of you people, and I have been actually delighted to present my opinion. In the end, when we say in the end, finally, I would like to thank you for your presence. Finally, I would like to thank you for your presence. So, in the end, I would like to thank you for the presence. So, in an informal way, we are saying in the end, when we are, I'm actually giving the ending of my speech. And formally, I'm saying, finally, I would like to thank you, all of you, for your presence. Next is, in the meantime, it is giving the formal way, in the interim. Yes, when you are in the mid of any communication, so you're explaining it loud, you're giving a situation that I was actually walking on the road and busy with my iPad, but in the meantime, I noticed that someone actually passed me. Right, so in the meantime means in the interim. So this is the way of a formal manner saying the same thing. In the meantime, in the between, in the meanwhile. Right, so that is what this is meant. Okay, next is anyway. Anyway is actually used to divert a conversation, to actually support a conversation, or to change a subject. In many places we use anyway, not with standing. Yes, this formal way is little, you know, complicated, but anyway is actually beautiful word to put between the words to divert to communication. Suppose I'm saying you, I had enjoyed the concert yesterday night and it was pleasant music around me. Anyway, I would like to mention one thing that I have seen one of my friends. So I had diverted my communication, right, by putting anyway in between that line. So anyway is diverting my line, diverting my communication. Anyway is actually supporting also my previous communication to the another one. I was actually enjoying the concert. Anyway, I forgot to mention that I met one of my friend there yesterday. So that is what anyway is. Next is, I think, which is actually informal way, and in my opinion is a formal way. I think I'm going to have a good vacation this summer, right? Because I have selected a beautiful place. In my opinion, I would like to give you a focus on the project. In my opinion, this project is actually going to work very well because the points have been selected on a beautiful note. So, in my opinion, when you're giving your opinion, you're saying, in my opinion, when you're putting your thoughts, formal way you're saying, in my opinion, that seems formal way, and when you say, I think this project is going to work very well, so that is informal way. Now, also, in addition to, right, this is a formal way. I would like to introduce Mr. Brown. He has worked very well in particular areas. Also, I would like to add some of his achievements. So, in addition, I would like to add one of his, many of his achievements. So also means it is connecting more communication. Also means you're adding another thing with the previous communication. So in addition to is actually a formal way and also is a informal way. Lots of formals and informals, but it is very important to learn, right? Next is but, right, which is informal. But how we say, I said but, how we say the same word with a sense of informal manner, that is however. So what it does, it just breaks the context. You are saying something, you are speaking a line in English. So when we use but or however, it actually breaks the context. doesn't change the meaning, but it breaks the context. I'm very delighted to be here and present my opinion in front of you, all of you. However, I'm not here to praise myself and speak a lot about myself. But I'm not here to say a lot of things about myself. So when we say however, I'm not here to speak a lot of things about me. I'm here actually to know you, to listen you. And that place, if I say but, so it sounds little informal, right? So it is actually breaking the context. It is actually again little bit diverting the context. Next is so. So another way, informal way, we say however. These boots are very soft and actually doesn't pain on the ankles. So it is very comfortable, right? Therefore, it is very comfortable when we put it on. Informal mails when we write, I'm not well, I'm not putting in a good health. Therefore, I would request you to grant me a leave. So there we write, I said so. Because I'm communicating you with you in a usual, in a just a non-formal manner, informal manner. So I'm using so. At many places I'm using so. So when we say therefore, right? So therefore, kindly grant me the leave. That's why grant me the leave. It is giving me a reason to grant a leave. We are using the word therefore. This word is very popular in a formal mail writing. Next is to sum up, right? To sum up, it means in conclusion. It was actually a very, you know, a kind of achievement for me to present my opinion in front of all of you. To sum up, I would like to thank you, all of you, for giving your presence in this context. So to sum up, or in conclusion, or in last, when you just, you know, sum up, you collect all your thoughts and you are giving the ending of your speech. So to sum up, or in conclusion, both are the two ways to present your views. Yes. Now, ASAP. As soon as possible. The same thing can be said, earliest convenience. Kindly revert me at your earliest convenience. This is actually a beautiful formal way to present your opinion. But please reply me as soon as possible. As earliest as possible, right? As soon as possible. So same thing you are saying, that in informal way and formal way. Very beautiful communication. Last is just the opposite. Another way, on the contrary, when you give your one opinion and that opinion has the another side also, then you use both these format in a formal way and informal way. Well, like you will say that I actually like to start a factory over there and the factory is going to run. On the contrary, there are other sides also which I need to put in my mind. So when they, something which have two sides, right? So that is a contrary. These sides are opposite. So then you say, on the contrary, just the opposite. You have one side, you are putting a factory, you are trying to set up a factory. On the contrary, there are many hurdles also that you need to cross, that you need to overcome. So in this way, we have learned that how we can use the same word in a formal way and informal way. And it also helps you, I will say, it also helps you to make your communication smarter and more beautiful. So use it and rock it. Bye.